Hi there, Miss Barber here. This lesson is titled Euler Paths and Euler Circuits. We have four learning objectives for this lesson. One, be able to define and find an Euler path. Two, be able to define and find an Euler circuit. Three, be able to apply Euler's theorem to solve graph theory problems. And our fourth learning objective for this lesson is to be able to use Fleury's algorithm to find Euler paths and Euler circuits. Euler paths definitions. One, an Euler path is a path that travels through every edge of a graph once and only once. Note, each edge must be traveled and no edge can be retraced. Use numbers to consecutively trace the path with your pencil. We'll let our Euler path start at vertex A. Following the arrow directions, A to B is 1. We'll go from B to C as path 2. C to E is 3. E to D as in dog is 4. From D as in dog to B as in boy is 5. We'll go from B as in boy to E as in egg, that's 6. From E, we'll go to F, that's 7. From F, we go to D as in dog, that's 8. And from D, we go to G, that's 9. Our Euler path ends at vertex G. Next, find a different Euler path that starts at vertex A and ends at vertex G on your own. Euler circuits definitions. An Euler circuit is a circuit that travels through every edge of the graph once and only once. Note, like all circuits, an Euler circuit must begin and end at the same vertex. Use numbers consecutively to trace the path with your pencil. We'll let our Euler circuit start and end at vertex A. Go from A to B, that's 1. From B to C, 2. From C to E, 3. We'll go from E to D as in dog, that's 4. We'll go from D as in dog to B as in boy, that's 5. From B, we'll traverse to E, that's our 6th step. From E, we'll go to F, that's 7. From F, we'll travel to D as in dog, that's 8. From D, we'll go to G, that's 9. And we'll go back to A. We make our circuit with the 10th step. Now find a different Euler circuit that starts at vertex A on your own. Example, by trial and error, find an Euler path for figure A and an Euler circuit for figure B. Take a few moments to try both of these. For figure A, one possible path, I'll start at E, then go to D as in dog, B as in boy, A as in apple, C as in cookie, B as in boy, E as in egg, C as in cookie, D as in dog. That's one path. You find one. For figure B, one possible circuit. I'll begin at E as in egg, go to D as in dog, B as in boy, A as in apple, C as in cookie, B as in boy, E as in egg, C as in cookie, D as in dog. dog, F as in funny, E as in egg. We made or completed a circuit. Example, for the graphs shown, determine if an Euler path, an Euler circuit, neither, or both exist. What did you determine? Euler's theorem. The following statements are true for connected graphs. 1. If a graph has exactly two odd vertices, then it has at least one Euler path and no Euler circuit. Each Euler path must start at one of the odd vertices and end at the other one. 2. If a graph has no odd vertices, that means all vertices are even, it has at least one Euler circuit, which by definition is also an Euler path. An Euler circuit can start and end at any vertex. And 3. If a graph has more than two odd vertices, then it has no Euler paths and no Euler circuits. Example 3a. Use Euler's theorem to explain why graph below has at least one Euler path. Solution. We can count the number of edges at each vertex to determine if the vertex is odd or even. I'll start at A. The degree is 2, therefore vertex A is even. Let's go to B. B is degree 4. It has 4 edges coming out of it, so B is also even. Let's look at vertex C. Vertex C has 4 edges coming out of it. That makes it a degree 4. And so vertex C is even. Let's look at vertex D. It has 3 edges coming out of it. That makes it a degree 3, and so that vertex D is odd. I'll give you a moment to figure out the degree of vertex E. Degree 3, right? You've got 3 edges coming out of it, so vertex E is odd. Now, we note that this graph has exactly 2 odd vertices. They are D and E. Thus, by the first statement of Euler's theorem, the graph has at least one Euler path and no Euler circuits. So we're going to use Euler's theorem to find an Euler path. One possible answer, we've got 2 odd vertices, D and E. I will start an Euler path at D and travel to C. Some of this is trial and error. We at least have a starting point. From C, let's travel to B. From B as in boy, we'll travel down to E. From E, we'll travel straight up to vertex C. From C, we will travel to A. From A, we'll go to B as in boy. From B, we'll go down to our starting point, which was D. And notice, all the paths except the last one's been traversed. And when we go from D to E, we have hit every single path once and only once, with the Euler path ending at E. What is the degree of the vertex where the Euler path both start and end? They are both 3. They're odd. Example, we can use Euler's theorem to solve problems involving situations modeled by graphs. Recall the graph that models the layout of Königsberg. Is it possible to walk across all of the bridges without having to recross any of the bridges. We count the number of odd vertices. I'll start with the north bank. Vertex N is degree 3. There are 3 edges coming out of there. Let's look at the center island C vertex. It has 5 edges coming out of it. We'll look at the right bank. It has a degree of 3. And finally, the south bank. It also has a degree of 3. So there are 4 odd vertices. Because the graph has more than 2 odd vertices, it has no Euler paths. Thus, there is no possible way to walk across all of the bridges without having to recross at least one of them. Example 5a. Use Euler's theorem to determine whether an Euler path or an Euler circuit exists for the following graphs. Our solution. Let's count the degrees of each vertex. Vertex A is degree 2. Vertex B has 4 edges coming out of it, so it's degree 4. Vertex C has 2 edges coming out of it, so that's degree 2. Vertex D as in dog has 4 edges coming out of it, so vertex D is a degree 4. Graph A has no odd vertices. That is, all vertices are even. Thus, by item 1 of Euler's theorem, at least one Euler circuit exists. And an Euler circuit can be determined by starting at any vertex. It will begin and end at that same vertex. Remember, an Euler circuit is also an Euler path. Example 5b. Use Euler's theorem to determine whether an Euler path or an Euler circuit exists for this graph. Our solution. Again, we count the degree of each vertex. I'll start with vertex A. It has 2 edges, so it's degree 2. Vertex B has 4 edges, so it's degree 4. Vertex C has 2 edges, so it's degree 2. Vertex D has 3 edges coming out of it, so vertex D is degree 3. And likewise for vertex E, it also has 3 edges coming out of it, so vertex E is degree 3. This graph has 3 even vertices. They are A, B, and C, and 2 odd vertices, D and E. According to item 2 of Euler's theorem, since we have exactly 2 odd vertices, there is at least one Euler path and no Euler circuits. Each Euler path must begin at one of the odd vertices and it will end at the other odd vertex. Be sure to take a few moments to find such a path. Example 6. Let's consider again the states that make up the Midwest region of the United States. Below is a graph that represents the map. Vertices represent the states. Edges represent common borders. One of the researchers wants to visit each state within the mapped region. To plan the most efficient trip, the researcher wishes to travel between these states and cross each common state border exactly one time. Part A. Is it possible to travel among the states and cross each common state border exactly one time? Solution. We are looking for an Euler path since we must use each edge exactly once. This graph has two odd vertices. Therefore, by item 2 of Euler's theorem, the graph has at least one Euler path. Thus, it is possible to travel among these states and cross each common border exactly one time. The researcher must start in either Kentucky or Indiana, which are the odd degree states or vertices, and end in the other state. If it's possible, can he start and end in the same state? Well, let's consider the solution. Unfortunately, the graph does not meet the criteria for an Euler circuit, which is that all vertices must be even. Therefore, the researcher cannot start and end in the same state. Fleury's algorithm. If Euler's theorem indicates the existence of an Euler path or Euler circuit, one can be found by using the following procedure. Step 1. If the graph has exactly two odd vertices, choose one of the two odd vertices as a starting point. If the graph has no odd vertices, choose any vertex as a starting point. 2. Number the edges as you trace through the graph according to the following rules. Bullet point 1. After you have traveled over an edge, erase it. Show the erased edge as a dashed line. Bullet point 2. When faced with a choice of edges to trace, first choose any edge that is not a bridge. A bridge is an edge whose removal would make the graph disconnected. And finally, bullet point 3, travel over a bridge only if there is no alternative. Example, if appropriate, use Fleury's algorithm to find an Euler circuit for the provided graph. Each vertex of this connected graph is even. Therefore, by Euler's theorem, we know that it has at least one Euler circuit. Here's our graph. Let's begin at vertex A and connect to vertex B. B has edges to E, F, and C. None are bridges. I'll choose to connect to C. From C, the only edge is to F, so let's connect to it. F has an edge to B, E, and G. None are bridges. I'll choose to connect to G. The only unused edge from G is to D, so we'll connect to D. The only unused edge from D is to E, so we'll connect to E. Keeping in mind that the circuit has to end at A, from E, the viable choices are F and B, and neither is a bridge. Let's connect to F. From F, the only path not yet traversed is to B. We'll connect to B. From B, the only path available is to E, so we'll connect to vertex E. And from vertex E, we have one untraveled edge remaining. That edge is to A, and that completes the circuit. We found one Euler circuit by Fleury's algorithm. Be sure to do a few on your own.